realized nothing like that. It is make your life much more peaceful wherever you are. So there are a lot of corruption has happened in the teaching and understanding. Okay, the Vedanta spirituality means so you go to monks, go to Himalayas, or sit in a weird way, put a weird dress. Nothing like that. It's for common ordinary people to make the mind peaceful wherever you are. Nothing more than that. So the whole system of teaching has got distorted over a period of time.
There's more awareness, and I'm aware of the divine, right?
Yeah.
You know, and where I'm operating from.
I am aware of the divine means what? The divine
no,
is
I
different.
Am the divine.
Ah, okay.
I am the divine.
Okay.
That's helped me a lot. It's me like it's peaceful.
Okay.
I feel
that. Very good.
And thinking has changed.
Thinking
way of thinking. I am not the doer.
Okay.
That's the main thing.
Husband takes care of you?
That's the main thing which has changed me.
Okay.
There is no fear, no anxiety.
Very good. Very good.
Everything is...
So that's all is Vedanta, okay? Vedanta is Abhayam. Abhayam means fearlessness.
Fearless.
The fear will go down. Okay, the spirituality doesn't mean that you put some malas, put this thing. Deep inside, the fear will go. Reduces. Stress will reduce. Okay? So, we have a very wrong, different notions of spirituality. Somebody wearing a dress, somebody wearing having a beard, somebody having a mala, okay, somebody sitting and closing his eyes for 4 hours, 5 hours, or standing on one leg. None of them are spiritual. They're all some external. Spirituality is deep inside. There's a peace, calmness.
I did a good reading where you're centered. So, when you remain in that center, you are just calm.
Yeah.
Outside things don't really bother you.
A lot of acceptance has come.
Very good.
Less reactive.
Very good.
In a lot of situations.
Really
helpful for me. Okay.
In my profession, in my household.
Very good.
It helped me, especially to role playing. And also, after coming to this class, I got to know the oneness with the universe. I feel the oneness with the universe.
Very nice.
That was the main change that I feel.
Very good.
Especially when I used to go to temple, I used to pray with the God, like kind of a business.
No, God prays to you?
No.
I just like, no, role has not changed. Baba, leave me, God. Actually, God prays every day. Baba, chod the bhai, clearly understand who you are. People think I pray to God. Actually, God prays every day. Guru prays. Baba, shishyas are coming every day with complaints. Baba, please understand yourself. Free me. I have already bonded, the Guru says. Okay.
And nowadays, I stopped and feel that oneness.
Okay.
I stopped praying.
Very good.
I just do the meditation with
them. There is no prayer required. Because everything what is required is happening.
Yeah.
Right? And did you have suffering in life? No suffering.
After coming to this class.
See, the suffering in life is not a suffering. Okay, there is no suffering in our life. So we think that I suffer because of husband, I suffer because of wife, I suffer because of my friend, I suffer because of my enemy.
Before this class, I suffer.
There is no suffering at all.
Yeah.
There actually is the cooking for you, some baking for you, so that you go for Atmadarshana, realize yourself. Okay, so there are actually a support system for you. If you are very, very comfortable, you will never bother about Atmadarshana or anything.
True.
Okay, actually, the temperature and heat will be increased if you are not boiled enough in life. Your husband, your wife, your children, everything is a gift from the God, okay, for cooking you, baking you, so that you become a very good, nice dish. Yes, Ravan. So, has it clarified anything of Vedanta more clear, this thing?
Yeah, this is slightly more understanding of what I is.
Okay.
But long way to go.
Long way to go. Okay.
For me, the thoughts have reduced a lot.
Very good.
And sometimes I feel weird when there is no thought, you know.
That's
rushing.
Good. That's okay.
Yeah.
That's okay.
If you are in case, like, you know, outward changing thing, the minute it starts agitating me, I immediately go back to that Sarat Samadhi.
Very good.
So it's a peaceful,
very nice
feeling. Yeah.
The Ramakrishna has made me a very peaceful
soul. Peaceful.
Most times to worry a lot.
Can you get a certificate from your son and husband that you have become peaceful?
I am peaceful inside.
I am peaceful inside.
So outside still.
Outside still. Certificate can get.
Anyhow, I silence.
Silence. Very good.
So there's been a lot of change. I'm much more peaceful now. A lot of acceptance, which has actually improved my interpersonal relationships.
Very nice. So, sir, does this any improve either, pa?
Role playing and peaceful.
Okay. Very good. Let us start now. Now today's class is you are God. After this, you can't ask any question and you can't pray anything to Guruji. Guruji, please free my suffering because you are God anyway. So, this is the way of getting rid of Shishas. Hey, Maitreya, do you want? Okay, I'm sure it's something. Okay. So, I'll tell you, start with a story which has really happened. Okay, there is a big Guru ashram. There are a lot of people there who are a resident. So, one lady comes, when Guruji comes to the ashram, catches hold of the feet of the Guru, and until you give me mukti, I won't leave your feet. she has learned from scripture very clearly. If you catch hold of feet of Guru, you get mukti. Guru is afraid to come to the ashram. This lady doesn't leave. So, it is very wrongly understood. Guru's feet means jnana. Okay, Guru's feet is not the physical feet. Nothing about Guru is physical. Okay, so people make it very, very wrong understanding and leads to a lot of. So, Guru's two feet are jnana and vairagya. Detachment and wisdom. That's the Guru's feet. Okay, so, and Guru Paduka is there. So the really they actually people worship Guru Paduka, not Guru's feet, because one who is wearing the Paduka has disappeared. He is no longer, oh, Guru has passed away. No, the person has disappeared. He is no longer individual. That's why Paduka is worshipped in India. Okay, why Paduka is worshipped? Because when traveling, he traveled a path. In the process of traveling, he disappeared. He is no longer individual. There's no individual left. Okay, only his foot, Paduka is left. So this is not about Guru dying and going to passing away. He's while alive himself, he has disappeared. Okay, he is no longer individual. So he is no individuality left. So the Paduka is remaining. The Paduka is remaining, symbolizing that what protected his walk is remaining. What protected his walk? Jnana and Vairagya. That's only remaining. And that's remaining in the form of teachings. So you worship that. So don't even worship the feet of the Guru. Because the feet of the Guru is not there. He disappeared. Guru is not a person. Okay. If he is a person, then he is not a Guru. Right? So now, the crux of Vedantic teaching is you are God. Okay. You are Shiva. Shiva is Jiva. Jiva is Shiva. You, whatever you call as yourself, is Shiva or God. Now, you understand what I'm saying? Is it easy to accept?
Easy to accept,
hard to remember. See, you have to remember things which are lies. Truth you don't have to remember, my dear. hard to remember it is the truth. look at your life. If you tell one lie, you'll remember it throughout your life. Because you have to always give supporting evidence for that. Okay? If you tell the truth, you don't remember. So it's hard to remember I am God is a very good sign. Whatever is untruth, you remember always. So I am a body, I am a woman. The falsehood is remembered more easily. That's why you understand, whatever you remember is false. Whatever truth, you don't have to remember.
You don't have to remember it.
Okay? So, if you are not able to remember that I am God, it's a very comfortable sign. As long as you understand, I am body, I am the mind, I am the intellect is false, you are fine. And whatever you are remembering is false. Untruth is more easily remembered. You remember in your life, you know, whole of your life you have told many lies. That lies you have to remember today also, because you have to consistently maintain that lies. But truth you don't have to remember, over. Okay? You understand? Now, you tell me, when I say you are God, okay, is it easy to accept it, sir? Huh?
Yes.
You don't know. Why you don't know?
No, it's difficult to accept. I don't know.
You difficult to accept. What about you? Easy to accept. Sorry?
Can accept it, but still it does not show up in life.
That's because you have some expectation of God. You understand? So what is the Vedantic meaning of God, you have to understand clearly. So there's a real meaning of Vedantic meaning, and there's a society meaning. So you need to understand very clearly and why you are God. Entire Vedantic teaching, this class, I could have finished this in one first class itself, this is where I could have taught you and finished the class. But you are not ready. So this class goes on and on and on, and for preparing you for this class. Okay. So Uma, when I say you are God, are you ready to accept? No. Why you are not ready to accept? I don't know. That is a problem. Okay. What about you? You can accept. Okay. Now prove that you are God. So those who said I can accept, I am God. You prove you are God. You said, okay, you prove that you are God.
As I said, it's the truth, no need to prove.
Okay, see the whole of Vedanta, all of your bundle of books, so many scriptures, so many Upanishads, okay, so many Bhagavad Gita, so much of chanting, so much of mantra, so mantra of japa, is only to tell you are God. Okay, one sentence, it's called Tattvamasi, three words. Okay, now let us understand these three words easily, more clearly. Tat means that. That is God. Why that is God? Because for you, the God is very far off, no? He is in Kailasa, he is in Vaikuntha, right? It cannot be here also. That is God. Okay, Shiva means actually I had a very difficult time. I used to say, Shivoham, Shivoham. I used to have one student, okay, who is an addict of that, the TV serial is that?
Mahadev.
Devo Shivoham, she is not able to accept. The Shiva means you have to have a bull. He has to live in Himalayas. How can I say Shivoham? So strong belief that Shiva means he should be in Kailasa only, nowhere else. So the serials, the stories, the Puranas have put so much into your head. Biggest job of the Guru is not to give the truth, to show what is untruth. Okay, so you are God, Tattvamasi is the teaching of entire Upanishad. Whatever you do, nothing more you will get. And no other religion in the world will teach you. Okay, only Vedanta teaches. But all religions in the world, they teach this indirectly. In Bible, okay, Moses goes on to the holy mountain, Moses, the prophet. So there's a bush, there's a light there. And burning bush. It gives the 10 commandments. Then he says, who gave this commandment? What should I tell people? Then the bush says, the burning, that is God says, I am that I am. Okay, he says that. Jehovah in Jewish religion, it means, Jehovah means I am that. So every religion has this thing, but over a period of time, the society has distorted the truth in such a way, you can't even understand what is the original truth. Okay? The simple truth is Shivoham. I am Shiva, consciousness. Now, is that the end of your suffering or is beginning of your suffering? Because I have not become Shiva, I don't have powers of Shiva. I wish I can make my husband vanish or wife vanish. You are Shiva as it is. Your husband and wife also is Shiva as it is. You cannot change anything. You have to take as is various condition. Okay? So now let us understand this very clearly. So, Tattvamasi, you are that. You are Brahman. Brahman means infinite. Brahat. Infinite. You are God. This comes from Chandogya Upanishad of Samaveda. So why it's told from Upanishad? Because we believe in Vedas. Okay, the teaching of Vedas is sacred for us. So some authenticity is to be given. Now if I come, husband comes and says, you are the moon to the wife. You know it, there's some mehata, some hidden motive there. The customer, the businessman is saying, customer is God. So there's a motive. I have to get money. Customer is a king. So there's a motive. The Upanishad says you are God, there's no motive. Nobody will give anything to them. Not your puja or respect also is not required. So there's no motive here. Okay, there's no hidden motive here that you are God. So there must be some truth in that. That's why people accept. So Vedas are accepted because it's understood that there's no hidden motive there. It's only our upliftment is there. Okay, your God is not another ego booster. Boosting your ego. So now, the moment you say you are God, the objections are raised. Right? What is the objection? How can I be God? I am so small, so limited. Right? God is infinite. God is all powerful, almighty. God knows everything. I am struggling to know even my phone number also. My phone number, forget about other phone number. So, I am small, I am finite. I don't have that power, ability. How can I be God? Is that a valid objection?
I'm not good enough to be God.
I am not good enough to be God. This is the objection, right? And also the society says, society also gives a label to you. You are smart, you are dumb. Okay, if you are not made a million, what kind of a person you are, no? If you are not looking, half as beautiful as the Miss World, then you are ugly. So many labels are given to you. Right? So now these labels we take more seriously than Vedantic teaching of God. That's why you're not able to accept. Whatever society gives a label, okay, is much more comfortable for us than the label given, than the actual truth given by Rishis, Guru or Vedanta, God. Which has to be more, we have to give more importance. The teaching of God or teaching of Vedanta, but only problem is we don't know, we are not taught this. Okay, we are not taught this. We are not taught this in a clear way, understandable way. So that's the problem. Okay, so somewhere in life we have to understand. The Vedanta says you are God. Simple. Okay, then the objection comes. I am small. Then one level of objection people say. It's a very big group of people. I cannot be God. Okay, the sentence is called Tattvamasi. You are that. You are God. So, immediate objection per se. The Sanskrit is a beautiful language. You can twist it a little bit and give a different meaning. the real meaning of tattvamasi is atattvamasi. You are not that. Okay? A is missing there. That you have to take from the earlier part of the sentence. Atattvamasi. You can never be God. This is what teaches. Madhvacharya teaches. Okay? Atattvamasi. You are not God. You cannot be God. But, okay, you are a servant of God. Okay, accept it. You are a servant of God. Accept it. Atattvamasi. You are not God. Atattvamasi. You are separate from God. You are a servant of God. Live your life as if you are a servant of God. Atattvamasi. Okay. This is the first meaning given. It's called Advaita, duality. Atattvamasi means you are a servant of God. So that's why in Vedanta class we teach a meditation called Soham. I am that. So in Advaita they teach Dasoham. Same Soham, you are Dasoham. I am servant of God. Okay? Please understand. Understand you are God. But don't live like God in the world. Live like a servant of God in the world. The moment you live like God, you will be crucified. People don't tolerate many gods. Understand you are a God, but don't live like a God. I mean, don't show to the society. Don't leave that to the world. This is for your peace. Okay? Don't go and claim that I am God to anybody. The moment you claim that, you are finished. Okay? You know, one person was crucified because he just didn't even claim that I am God. He claimed I am son of God. Society doesn't tolerate that. Okay? So, Dasoham means I am servant of God. That's how you have to live in the world. But that's not the reality. Okay? So, why it is said so? Okay? The real is simple. Tat, Tam, Asi. You are that. Only three words now. Right? Tat, Tam, Asi. These three words mean three different things. Okay? For example, this is mobile. This is remote. This is table. They are referring to three different things. So since they are referring to three different things, they cannot be same. They must be telling some relationship in them. The mobile is on the table. That's okay. So that means tattvamasi means there's a relationship between you and God is told. What is the relationship? You are a servant of God. This teaching is called Dvaita. You understand? This teaching is called? You are servant of God. So, how can three words say? Three words will only say three different things. No sir, my dear sir. The three words or 10,000 words also can say about same thing. Do you know examples? Vishnu Sahasranama is there, which means 1,000 names of Vishnu. Vishwam, Vishnu, Vashatkara, Vat, Bhutapavya, Bhavat Prabhu. They are saying 1,000 things. They are not saying 1,000 things. They are thousands of things. About what? Only Vishnu. So, even three words can speak about only one thing. So, this is the objection which is given to people who come from the Dvaita argument. Tat, Tam, Asi cannot mean same thing. They are three different things. Because three words, no? No, my dear sir, three words also can mean same thing. Or 10,000 words also can mean same thing. I have an example, Vishnu Sahasranama. Vishwam, Vishnu, Vashatkar, all are meaning same to Vishnu only. Huh? Right? Uma calls, this is a husband. Son calls, father. But ultimately, it's with different names, different words, but only one fellow is there. Right? One poor fellow is there. So, all the three words, Tat, Tam, Asi, are referring to only one reality. It is not spelling separation. Okay? So, that doesn't mean that Dvaita is wrong. Dvaita is telling you about the way of living in the world. Okay? You understand you are God, but live as a servant of God. Because you are as an instrument, body mind instrument. Right? The moment you say you live as God, then you have a trouble. Okay? Society doesn't accept it. Unless you show some miracles and magics and they'll ask for a proof, demand a proof. which you can't do anyway. But for you, your life itself is a miracle. Having married, having two children, raising two children is a big miracle in life. The society doesn't accept it. Make a day-to-day living and work in IT industry for 10 years, 15 years. Oh, such a big miracle I have never seen. I don't think anybody has made such a miracle. Still, you'll ask a miracle. You are God. Show me the miracle. My dear, I have a miracle. How I am surviving? See, I am surviving. After working for 30 years in IT industry and I am still intact. That's a big miracle. People don't understand that miracle. They want some what is it? People prefer rum and whiskey out of water. At least wine out of water.
Vibhuti out of air.
That they call as miracle. They don't understand. If you survive in software industry for 1 year, such a big miracle doesn't exist. Okay, if you are married and you have two children and the grown-up children, my God, such a miracle. So, the society thinks these are all common things. Don't worry, this is not a miracle at all. If you are God, show me proof. So that's why don't claim as a God to anybody. Understand yourself and become peaceful. That's what Dvaita is teaching. Okay, don't think Dvaita is teaching anything else. Say, work in the society as a servant of God. Okay, that's a teaching, a way of living. Okay, don't say there is a conflict between Dvaita, Advaita and Vishishta Advaita. There is no conflict at all. Okay, the conflict is in only in your mind. Okay, Advaita is only truth, Dvaita is not truth. No. They are actually telling three different things. How to live in the world, it is telling. Okay, never claim, okay, by mistake that I am God to anybody. No, to you know yourself and be peaceful. So this is the biggest mistake you will do in life. You understand? Because people have variety of concepts about God. So don't get into that trouble. So the moment you tattvamasi, three different words are there, then I'll say, oh, these three different words means only one thing. Right? Like husband, wife, a husband, father and son mean about the only one person. Three words are there, but they are referring to only one. Like the tattvamasi is referring to only one. Okay, what is that one? We have to find out. Is it clear? So now the second question comes. Tattvamasi means, okay, first thing was three different words, they must be showing some relationship. Right? So second question comes. Oh, tattvamasi means that it must be something like a adjective. We are saying God, Vishnu is great, Vishwam, Vishnu, Vashakara, so many adjectives are given. Okay? So now, like that, you are also adjective of God. You are also one quality of God. Okay? So God is infinite, so you are a small piece, right, of God. Okay? You are for example, God is infinite, you are like a finger of God.
Model of God.
Huh?
Model of God.
Model. One body.
One model of similar.
No, not similar. You are a small piece.
Piece.
Okay. Similar is coming in the this thing. Dvaita. You are separate, similar. Okay. Whereas in Vishishta, in second call, this thing, God is infinite. You are a small piece. That's why it comes in Bhagavad Gita. Mamai Vamsha Sambhuta Jiva Bhuta Sanatanaha. Jivas are like my Amsha. Okay. Like finger is my Amsha. Finger operates based on my body. Right? Finger is my part. So you are a part. This is what Vishishta Advaita is. Ramanujacharya said that. You are a part of God. You can never be God. Okay? Right? So it's like an adjective. So for example, the red one is running, I'll say. Red one. So red one refers to red horse running. Okay. You are only telling the adjective. The red color. Others understood. So now, you means Shravan. You, Tvam means you. You are an adjective of God. One small part of God. Is this more acceptable? So So that's called God is whole and we are all parts. So the jiva, the world, the jagat and individuals are adjective of God. Right? Like for example, red rose. Tvam is nothing but adjective for tat. We don't accept that also. It is not that here you are God, tat and tvam are same thing. They are not different. It's not given as adjective. That's why it's called Vishishta Advaita. Vishishta is adjective. Okay? You and God are not different. You are God. Full stop. Okay? So now the scratching starts. How I can be God? Right? I cannot be God. Very simple. Why you cannot be God? You have to need apples and oranges, you cannot compare. Right? Apples and oranges, you cannot compare. God is based on faith. Nobody has seen God. But I am not faith here, I am really there. I am really there. He is shaking. Okay? I am really there. I don't know whether God is there or not. Yeah. I don't know whether God is there or not. Okay? How can you compare who am I existing with God who don't even know whether I exist or not? Right? You have to compare something existing. Okay, I can say I exist and you exist because I can see you. God who knows who exists or not? Huh? You have to compare apple and orange. You tell me something which I can say relate to existing one and existing one. For all you know, God may not exist at all. Right? How can you compare existing with the non-existing or a reality with a concept? I am the reality. I am seeing, see, I am very real. God, I don't know. Now, you are saying I am, which is real. With God, it's unknown, don't know, doubtful case.
You're saying as I am God.
That I'm saying God. So you are telling me, this is an objection I face from my students every day. I am existing. You are telling me Atma doesn't die. Don't you see it? How can I say I am Atma? How can I say Brahman? So, existing one, you are trying to compare it something more based on the faith. Correct? And of course, I have heard, I don't know, God is omniscient, He knows everything. He is omnipresent, He is everywhere. Okay? And He is all powerful. Alright? I am small, little, okay? Very weak, right? I am absent minded, even when I am present in front of my wife.
Especially.
So, how can I be omniscient? How can I be omnipresent? Right? I can be only here, I cannot be there. I wish I could be. I can be sitting at home enjoying the World Cup today and office also, but it's not possible. So, I am not omniscient and omnipresent. So, you are relating two things which are impossible to relate. This is an objection, right? See, our beautiful of Sanatana Dharma, okay, is it's not being based on the belief. It is not based on the faith. Now, whatever you say, believe in God and all has not come from Sanatana Dharma. The belief in God has come from the religions other than Sanatana Dharma. So now you have started thinking that it's your own. Sanatana Dharma says either you know or you don't know. Better to know clearly, that's all. Okay, God is based on the faith. Faith is based on the belief. Whereas I am not based on faith. I am there. Okay? So now these two sentences, this sentence somehow I have to make a meaning out of this sentence, Tattvamasi. How do I make out the meaning of this? Okay? So now, very simple. Sanskrit is a very, very powerful language. Okay, you can add something little bit or delete something and create a meaning out of that. So add a meaning to that. Alright? What is the added meaning? By adding something to me, I will become God. What will I add? Some supernatural powers. Give me some supernatural powers, I will become God. Right? Little bit add something. Then I will become God. I am God, I accept it. But right now,
I don't feel.
So add a little bit of supernatural power. Just ability to see through third eyes, or ability to do astral travel, or ability to read the mind of somebody. So give a little bit of siddhis, powers. Then what will happen? I accept, I am God. May not be as infinite as God, but little bit I can do with some couple of siddhis. At least I can, if I am able to read my wife, mind of my wife or husband, it's a great achievement. I can accept I am God. This is one way of making sense out of this sentence, okay? Otherwise it's meaningless. Are you able to understand? Huh? So this sentence, as it is, doesn't make sense to me. I am real, God is unreal. So how I am relating, at least I have to add something, masala. Make a little bit supernatural power to me, then I will become very nice, no? No, it's not possible. I didn't say you have to become God, you are God. Okay? That's not acceptable. Adding something is not acceptable to this sentence. Okay, I am not adding so many different things. Just add little bit closest thing. I mean, I am not asking supernatural power. Little bit something, so that I feel like God. Little bit. What is that little bit? Which makes sense. For example, somebody says, my house is on the river. Okay, my house is on the river. Logically, it doesn't make sense. Okay, my house is on the river. It doesn't make sense. So then you have to add me a sense to that meaning. What is that? My house is on the bank of the river. So bank you all only omitted. Something you have not said in this sentence. You have only told three words, no? Tattvamasi. Something you have missed out. One word you have missed out somewhere. Which makes more sense. Okay? So the word or something missing word is there in this. If I add that missing word, maybe I accept I am God. Right? Little bit, one small word, something may be missing in that. Tattvamasi. There are only three words. Like, my house is on the river. Okay? Does not make sense. But people understand it. So it means that my house is on the river bank. So like that, you are God. Some related word must be missing in this. What is that related word? No, sir. Not a single word is missing. Vedanta Vakya, you cannot add one word and delete one word. Okay? Tattvamasi, Tattvamasi. So you have to accept it as it is. Okay, then how do I make sense out of this? God is based on the faith. I am reality. How do I join this? So then, probably, remove something which is superficial. Remove which is not essential. Okay? Remove something which is superficial and then you can call it as God. I am God. That seems to be a logical way of understanding this. Others, it doesn't make sense. I am God, how does it make sense? Remove something superficial and find the meaning. Tattvamasi is the word theory, but something superficial you have to remove. That's how you have to make the sense out of this word called Tattvamasi. What is that superficial? What is that superficial?
That.
That is superficial. Remove that. What is superficial? Is the question. Right? So in Vedanta, Nirguna Brahma or absolute reality is called Sat Chit Ananda. Existence, consciousness, bliss is called Nirguna Brahma. Okay? So that Nirguna Brahma is also called absolute. So little bit masala you add to that. It's called Maya. Then he becomes God. The creator. All powerful Ishvara. Saguna Brahma. Whomever you worship as God, all powerful, almighty, is Nirguna Brahma plus Maya. Okay, then who is individual? Same Satchitananda plus ignorance called Avidya. Then becomes Jiva, which is you. Tom. Now add little bit superficial. Remove the superficial called Maya from this guy and ignorance from you. Then you are God. Equation is balanced. The equation becomes this thing. Maya is superficial. Okay, to God. What means Maya means he makes become powerful, all magical, omnipresent, omniscient. Okay? Avidya makes you small. Okay? And limited. So these two is not an essential part of you, it's a superficial part of you. Remove avidya from you and Maya from God. Then you are one. Right? So this is the way it has to be understood. Ignorance from you has to be removed and Maya has to be removed from God. Then what happens? Both are absolute. That's called Parabrahma, Supreme Reality. And you are that Parabrahma. When you say you are God, doesn't mean that tomorrow I will be able to fly from fly in the sky. The powers of Maya don't come to you. Okay? That is not the meaning. Then next objection will rise. What is the use of powerless God? What is the use of powerless God? I wish I can become God, but I want to become powerful God. If you remove Maya and if you remove Udya, what the hell I do with the powerless God? Give me something useful now. If I have to become God, I am becoming God because I have to be powerful. Now you are saying I am powerless God. Who wants such God? Even if you give the equation, what is the use of that equation? You understand? Huh? What is the use of becoming powerless God? Satchidananda is powerless. The powers are Maya. That's removed. What is the use of becoming powerless God? Is there any use of becoming powerless God? Huh? All this Vedanta is teaching me to become powerless God. What is the point?
So much effort and struggle
to read this thing to become a powerless God. Huh? I am good enough as a husband. I have no powers. My wife Maya has all the powers. That I know already. What is the use of becoming a powerless God? Is this Vedanta teaching you to become a powerless God? Now you understood the tattvamasi, right? You tell me, do I proceed and do something to conduct the class? What is you becoming a powerless God? Arthaitendrappa? What is missing was Ananda. Okay? The Ananda part was missing in Jiva. Okay? The bliss. So by knowing I am Brahman, you will gain back the bliss. You will not get the powers. That's the whole teaching of Vedanta. Ananda is what was missing in your life. All your life you are searching for Ananda. Now that missing part is what you are getting by becoming Tattvamasi. you are not claiming that you are not gaining power. Okay, rather you are gaining ananda. Then after that, no power will matter to you. The power doesn't matter to you.
Because power is again the mind.
What is that? Power doesn't matter. No? If you are blissful, what will you do with power? No? Huh? If you are restless only, you will start wanting, looking for power. If you are blissful, what power you look for? The whole point is, see, these are important things, okay? Don't miss one single sentence of what I say. Then you will not understand this, you will not hear anywhere. So first I said, first Tattvamasi Vakya, I said, you are separate from God, you are servant of God. Because Tattvamasi, three words mean different things. That I gave you example, that three words mean different things is not true. Three words, all 10,000 words also can mean about same thing. Like Vishnu Sahasrama, I give example, right? So that objection is overruled. Okay. Now second comes is, Tattvamasi means, it must be tum, you, must be an adjective of that, right? Like you are an individual, you are a part of that Brahman. Okay, that's not so. You as not an adjective of God.
So it's like you are an engineer means, I mean,
you are engineer means?
Engineer is just adjective and you are
you. You are. So it's not an adjective.
The word was meant in that fashion. Was
yeah, it's not an adjective. Now the third important objection comes. God is faith. I don't know whether God exists or not. People say believe in God, believe in God. Okay, I don't know. Everybody says different way. So I am real. So how you can equate to one is unknown and other is real? You should compare apple and orange. If you can't compare apple and orange, you have to compare both. I am real and you are real, you can compare. But I am real and God is faith, I cannot compare or I cannot equate. Right? So then the objection is, then there must be some meaning should be added. So one meaning I would like to add is, add some superpower to me. I'll become powerful. Then I'll become God. Are you understanding what I'm saying? Maitri? I have to become God, I have to add some superpowers. No, that's not true. So then, there must be some close meaning missing. You have told correct Tattvamasi, but some, say for example, there is a river on the, house is on the river. House cannot be on the river. It's understood. What is river? House is on the river bank. Bank is missing. Tattvamasi, something is missing. No. Vedanta Vakya is three words means three words only, not one word more. So then, next comes, okay, you have to remove something. The example is, for example, okay, I brought a mango, Alfonso mango from the market. Okay, I brought an Alfonso mango from the market, clear? Then I ate an Alfonso mango. So what mango I brought and what mango I ate, are they one and the same? They are not same. I didn't eat the
same.
The peel I didn't eat. That inside what is there?
Seed.
The seed I didn't eat. I ate only the edible portion of the mango. But what I say? I ate the mango. Right? That means the essential part of Tattvamasi you have to take. You have to remove?
Skin and the seed.
Is it understood? You have to understand the essential part of Tattvamasi. What is the essential part of Tattvamasi? So here, absolute reality is called Sat Chit Ananda. It's called Nirguna Brahma or Brahman, Parabrahma. Okay? Brahman plus Maya. Now Maya, don't start thinking of something, some girl's name. Okay, Maya means perception. Various kinds of perception. Okay, for example, the sky appears blue. but sky is not blue. It's a perception. The world appears as real. It's not. It's a perception. So the Maya plus God absolute, Satchidananda plus absolute is called God, all powerful God. When you call as Rama, Krishna or Vishnu, they are all Maya plus absolute. So in our Veda, in our Sanatana Dharma, Satchidananda is called Narayana. Okay? He is resting. Okay? Where is Lakshmi now? Lakshmi is not visible. She is in the heart. Now when she wants to wake up Narayana, she comes and sits at the feet of Narayana, starts pressing. Thank God she is not pressing the... She wakes him up.
She wants something... doesn't get it.
Now Narayana wakes up in his dream and takes the form of Vishnu. The Saguna Brahma is Vishnu. Okay? Okay, there is absolute Narayana plus Maya, which is now the Shakti, the Lakshmi. Together they have become. Lakshmi means what? Lakshmi means Laksham. Where our attention goes, it's Lakshmi. That's why perhaps perception. Narayana plus perception becomes the Vishnu. Lakshmi means Laksham. Dhana Lakshmi, Dhanya Lakshmi, Santana Lakshmi. Okay, I don't know. Nowadays Santana Lakshmi, nobody gives attention. Nowadays 100 children is great Santana. Now one is also becoming difficult. Dhana Lakshmi, Dhanya Lakshmi, Aishwarya Lakshmi, Raja Lakshmi, all glittering wealth is Lakshmi. That means perception. And Narayana plus Lakshmi takes the form of Vishnu. Okay? Narayana is resting, but Vishnu is all around. That is Saguna Brahma. It's all powerful. Okay? So, the Satta Chitta Ananda plus Maya is called God. Then Jiva means you, Sat Chit Ananda plus ignorance, avidya. Okay? So, now what I said earlier, eating mango means throw the seed. So similarly, take out the Maya from God, take out the ignorance from you, then what remains is what? Satchidananda. Okay? That is called Brahman and that's what you are. Now a big objection comes. God became powerful because of Maya only. You remove Maya, you remove power from God. He is a powerless God. And you are making me a powerless God. Okay? You are removing ignorance from me and removing Maya from God and making me a powerless God. Who wants this Vedanta teaching? You tell me. I want to be a powerful God. Right?
What is perception and power actually? Attention is another. I will take Maya as a retention. What is it? You can say Jiva also has some attention. He also has some perception. That's not avidya. He also has some avidya. Avidya, he is actually within Maya. Jiva is coming in picture, which addition avidya. Jiva is a subset of Saguna Brahma. In appearance in Maya, Jiva is also appearance. There in relation Jiva has a avidya. I am the body.
God has no avidya that I am the body. He is consciously exercising his powers, whereas Jiva is unconsciously stuck in the powers.
So the God you are saying is Ishwara.
Ishwara.
Not the Brahman.
No, no. Brahman. Yeah. Ishwara, Ishwara, Ishwara is called Saguna Brahma. Manifest God. Saguna Brahma. Manifest. Vishnu is Saguna Brahma. Narayana is Parabrahma. Are you clear? Now the objection is, what is the use of becoming a powerless God? All these days, I studied 10 Upanishads, Brahma Sutra, Bhagavad Gita, finally to realize I am a powerless God. That I have already realized after marrying for 30 years, I know. I don't need Upanishads for that. Okay, so here, do you gain anything by becoming powerless God, Maitri?
No, create the power
anymore. What is missing was Ananda was missing in Jiva. The bliss. Ananda means infinity. Okay? the infinity part was missing in jiva. If you feel you are infinite, you don't care for power, right? I am infinity is the realization which is Vedanta teaching. Rest of things you don't need anything else. Okay, so now let me ask you a question. Okay, do you exist? Answer is yes or no.
Yes.
Right? You exist. That is called Sat. Are you conscious?
Yes.
That's called Chit. Are you happy and blissful? Who will be? Tell me, Guruji, on Sunday morning, if I am happy and blissful at my home, why should I come to this class? So, you know your Sat, you know your Chit. Okay, you are two-thirds God already, two-thirds Brahman already. But large missing part is Ananda part is missing. Are you clear? Whole of our life is not search for God. Whole of our life is not search for a wife or a husband. We are searching for Ananda.
So what is Ananda?
Ananda means infinity. Ananta.
Ananta.
What is Ananta? It's called Ananda.
So if Ananta is what is missing, that is because of the limitation of something. So
yeah.
It's not an addition. Ignorance. How we are saying Satchidananda plus ignorance is jiva then?
Yeah, that's because ignorance is a limitation is imposed on you.
It's an imposition.
Limitation is perceived by you.
And then that the same thing is also perception, right? Absolute plus perception also is a perception.
Yeah, it is. From jiva's point of view, it's perception only. That's why it's God is concept.
So infinity being either magnified or ascended. <is the
difference>. Infinity is made to appear as magnificent or minuscule. That's a perception. Right? Everything is a perception. Maya means, my definition of Maya is perception. Okay? I don't know if Vedanta says like that, but it's a perception. Right? So, Ananda is what we are looking for. The boy is after the girl, not because of the girl, but he seeks happiness from the girl. The poor creature, the girl also doesn't have happiness. Both are trying to snatch away some happiness from each other. There's a tug of war for getting happiness from each other. Okay? So, somebody is getting happiness from promotion. Okay? He gets a misery. Right? We are constantly looking for expansion. Expansion in terms of children, expansion in terms of money, expansion in terms of wealth, or expansion into the tire and the stomach. Somewhere you're looking for expansion. The whole of your life search is for expansion. And the expansion is called Ananda, infinity. Right? You understand? So, by Vedantic knowledge, you gain back the infinity by removing wrong perception. That's called avidya. Are you clear? So what is the wrong perception? Nanu. Nanembudu. Nanalla. Ideha. Mana buddhi. Nanalla. Sachidanandatma. Shivanannani. Shivoham. 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 You have to recognize you are not the body, you are not the mind, you are not the intellect. So then I become, I don't know what I am. Okay? This is the first part of realization. Then you realize the body is you, the mind is you, the intellect is you, the world is you. You are the totality. Right? You are not the body, you are not the mind, you are not the intellect, you are isolating. Then you realize that I am the body, I am the mind, I am the world, I am the infinity. So both has to happen. First part is called Aham Brahmasmi, second part is called Sarvam Kalida Brahma. All these Brahman. So you are no longer individual. So if you are able to give up your individuality, you gain the world. Right? That's the teaching of Veda. So is that clear? Tattvamasi Vakya meaning? Any questions?
You assume the answer first and then you know answer is the answer.
Huh? You know,
you first assume the answer first, and then the answer is the